Hey guys, so I'm back. First, I want to say thank you to everyone who watched all my videos, who subscribed and everything already. I received really, really good feedback, and I was surprised by how, friendly and receptive everybody was. So thank you. And if you're returning, cool. If you're new, subscribe. So my video today is going to be about something that is sort of near and dear to my heart because it was something that I complained about for a long time. When I first started doing this a year ago, I was really, really bad at keeping track of what I was doing as far as trading because I didn't really think that I was going to be doing this long term. I didn't really know what to think, to be honest with you. So I didn't keep the greatest track of things, and then when I started to, it was a learning curve. I just want to go over some apps, some websites, some things that I have used in the past, things that I like, why I like them, and the ones that I stopped using. So my first one is Folio. It's got price notifications are great. Not all of these apps have that, and some of the websites, you can't really do it because if you're not on the website, it doesn't help you. 24-hour market data, it's got the charts, it's got the order book, which is really cool. I think it might be the only app that has the order book, which is nice. There's a news option, so you can go under and see kind of what's going on related to cryptocurrencies and as a whole. They do have a Telegram chat. I can't speak to how active they are on it because I've never been in it myself. They most recently added a passcode lock and hiding your balances, which is really important. And it's for iOS and Android, which is nice. Okay, so now for the cons. I don't like that on the app, the percent change next to the numbers is the overall percent change for the coin itself, not your holdings, because it's aggravating for me to have to go into each individual holding and look at, you know, the transactions or whatever. The other thing I didn't like is that I found the Folio took a long time to add things like ICOs and weird coins like Regal. That's when I ended up starting to download multiple different apps because I found that some did what I wanted and each has their own strength and weakness, and so it's very frustrating. I also found, and I don't know if anybody else experienced this, that when I'd enter the date on Folio, I'd go back to the transaction and the date would be wrong. I don't know why it was doing that, but it was aggravating because I'd go back to look at a transaction and it wouldn't match up with the Excel spreadsheet that I keep. So I'm a stickler for the way stuff looks too. I really like it to be aesthetically pleasing so that I want to use it. And I just found that Folio, I don't really like the way it looks. I know that might sound really stupid, and I've actually gotten crap for it when I've said that because people tell me, well, it really doesn't matter how it looks, it just matters how it works. So if I don't like the way it works and I don't like the way it looks, I'm not going to use it. So needless to say, I don't use Folio anymore. The next app that I use and I love is CoinDex. One of the things that I found that immediately I liked was that it had multiple portfolios because I like to track things that I'm keeping long-term that I'm just holding, and I like to track things separately from that I'm actively trading. My favorite thing is probably the overall profit loss percent is related to what you're holding. This one also has 24-hour market data and charts. It doesn't, however, have an order book, but to be honest with you, that's not really something I used anyway, so I wasn't too worried about it. It has a pie chart breakdown showing percentages of, you know, how much coin makes up your portfolio, which I think is cool. It has news as well. And one of the greater things I think is that it has an upcoming ICO section. So there's a little tab you go over and it'll show. It's not all of them, obviously, but it's a pretty significant amount and it has a countdown into what one's going to be soonest. Something else I really liked is if you sell off the coin as a whole, the coin doesn't disappear from the portfolio. It stays static and it just shows your profit. The guy who designed it has a Telegram chat and he's awesome. His name is Jason. He's on there all the time. He's always taking recommendations from people. He's always willing to listen to ideas and improvements. He updates it very, very frequently. This is also an iOS and Android app, so that's good. The cons. Because it's a relatively new app, it can get a little weird once in a while, and Jason, when he updates it, will find that there's quirks or whatever, and he'll figure it out. But one of the bigger ones that has since been resolved but was a real issue for me was the app converts Bitcoin to USD so I can track my prices in USD, which I know is, you know, the crypto peers get pissed because they think that that's not the best way to do it, but I can't look at a Bitcoin price and translate it to what it is in USD. I don't have a mind for it, so I need the app to do it for me. And the problem with that was, when it was converting incorrectly, basically. So a lot of the coins were telling me I had a negative profit when I didn't. And I told him about it, I sent it screenshots, and he figured it out. It was fixed within a week. It doesn't have a night mode, and it doesn't have a passcode lock, so it also doesn't hide the balances, so if that's something that you're really worried about, you know, this app may not be for you. Be aware, there's two CoinDex apps on the iOS marketplace, and the one I'm talking about is Purple. My next one is CoinStats. CoinStats, one thing that I really love is that it has a bubble. You can do a bubble alert on the app itself, so on your home screen it'll show a price of a specific coin. So for right now I have it set for Block, because I have a large holding of Block and I want to see what the price is at all times. When you go to the home screen, I like that it's separate from the portfolio and has a huge list of CoinMarketCap coins. And again, for aesthetics, there's this little graphic that goes across the screen when you open the app that kind of highlights the price movement. And I think it's pretty, so I'm a fan of that. There is a news section and there is a pie chart section showing percentages for your holdings, again, just like CoinDex. And this app seems to be the one that gets the off-brand coins like Regal and things like that very quickly. You can also sync your profile across multiple devices, which is cool and definitely convenient. And it's also for iOS and Android. The cons for me on this one are kind of big. When you enter your trades, they're out of order in the list. So say I made a trade 3 days ago and I forgot to enter it and I'm remembering to do it now. The dates aren't sequential and that drives me nuts. I also found that like Blockfolio, for whatever reason, sometimes the entry date is wrong. It's because you have to scroll through it and I find that I'll double check, I'll look and see and it's the right one and then I'll go back and it's changed and it's not. There's pay for premium feature, which is kind of aggravating, but premium features are pretty good, price alerts and things like that. So you can either buy it or you have three of your friends download the app with your referral code and you get it for free, which is what I did. Now, this is the big one that I don't like. If you sell off your whole holding of a coin, unlike CoinDex, which keeps it static on your profile and you can get rid of it if you choose to, it disappears. And I haven't had the time to figure out if it's still being calculated into your total portfolio value, like if you sold up or down, if it's still affecting it even when it disappears. I sometimes forget, you know, what I even had, and the Excel spreadsheet thankfully is my backup, so I have that, but it would be nice if the app did that too. Okay, so now for websites. The big one that everybody knows is coin tracking. So the pros are it's super technical as far as tracking goes. You've got trade analysis, you've got trade stats, realized and unrealized gains like anything else. You have multiple ways to import, so you could do an API, you could do a bulk, you can do like an Excel thing that you could do yourself. It has the ability to calculate your taxes too, which is nice. I think you have to pay for the extra feature, but it's still a good option. Obviously, there's all these questions about what happens when we really do sell and we're no longer holding and we have to pay taxes on these things, or if people are going to pay taxes on these things, I don't know. So that's kind of a cool feature. I will say that they have fantastic customer service. I emailed them and they emailed me right back. The guy's very nice, very helpful, and willing to work with the fact that I bought it twice and wanted a refund twice. So now for the cons. So you can import through API or bulk imports with the Excel spreadsheet, like I said, but it's very cumbersome. It doesn't take into account deposits and withdrawals. So if you know, put a whole bunch of coins in somewhere and then move them out, it's gonna show a deficit. And the problem with me was, I started using it after the GDAX flash crash. I was in that. I had an open long on ETH and it was a mess. I had been trying to figure out how much I lost because they refunded me my original Ethereum, but what I was worried about was what I had lost as far as profit. And the guy basically just bulk imported a bunch of stuff for me and it worked, but it wasn't really as accurate. There was no trades, it was just a number. So I ended up not using it. You have to manually enter a lot of your trades if you really want it to be specific and accurate, which is aggravating. The other thing is there is an app for it, but it only shows your portfolio value. You can't edit what you're holding, which is, I mean, useful, but also, I mean, who knows, maybe they're gonna add it. So it holds max 200 trades for free, I should add. There's two different kinds of upgrades you can do to your profile, but you have to pay for them. So my next website is CryptoCandor. I like that it pulls data from its own site, so it's very, very up to date, and it's very accurate. It has risk analysis, so it shows, you know, what your positions are open versus what you're holding on an exchange to, which could be worrisome if you're not putting it in a wallet. There's active profit and loss on each individual trade, showing if you're up or down on each one, which is nice. It also shows active profit and loss on the portfolio as a whole as well. There's an accounting section for taxes, like coin tracking, which is cool. It's a little bit more basic and it's free, but it still does the job. I think that the UI is great. It's clean, it's easy to understand and use, and you get what you see, and there's no room for interpretation. It's very black and white. And my favorite thing probably is the sold option. So unlike some of the apps where your sold coins disappear, CryptoCandor takes your coin, puts it on another sold tab, and you can go look at everything. Cons. So it doesn't keep a running tally of your holdings for each coin. So if you, you know, did five trades of, let's say, Vertcoin, right? It shows the trades individually. It doesn't show an overall holding, which is kind of silly. But again, I use this and I use CoinDex and I use CoinStats. So I have stuff all over the place, but that would be nice if they added that. It has no app, which is kind of frustrating, but obviously it's a website with a whole lot of other features too. It's not specifically for the portfolio. So I understand probably why they haven't done it. And the other thing is it takes a really, really long time to add off-brand stuff like Regal. It takes forever. So I have to use, again, another app to track those because the website doesn't do it for me, and that's okay. And my last website is Alt Pocket. It is one of the ones that I found a long time ago that I was using in the beginning a lot. I really, really liked it. I liked it. The UI was fun. It's got like a social aspect to it. You can share portfolios with your friends, or you can see how your trades are doing compared to how other people's trades are doing. If you want, it can be privated too, which I'm sure most people will private it because the crypto space isn't really one for sharing things like that. It shows individualized trades like CryptoCandor, which is nice, but it would be cool if they organized it by each coin and then you could open the coin and see the trades individually, just to make it less busy. You can do API connections and you can do auto imports and you can manually import, which is cool, so there's some options. The only downside to that right now is they're only using, it's only importing from Polo and Bittrex. They make a conscious effort to really talk to the people that are using their site. Their dev team's really involved, so that's good. It's got a great variety of coins, and I also like that it has a balances section. So unlike CryptoCandor that doesn't give you a running tally of what you're holding, AltPocket does. So the cons. I haven't used the site in a while since I found CryptoCandor, but what happened is when they were moving over to like their 2.0 version of the site, they wanted everybody to re-import all their coins through new APIs. And for whatever reason, my API imports were importing things that I had sold months ago. So I could never get the site really to work for me again after that. But I know people that use it right now that say that it's very, very good and they've been successful with it. And it could likely be because they started using it after the upgrade. Who knows? If you want something very basic, that's really what it is. It's very simple. There's no bells and whistles like coin tracking or CryptoCandor. But, you know, it gets the job done. Again, it's it is what it is. There's tons of apps, there's tons of websites, there's tons of resources, and I really just singled it down to the things that I use or the things that I really feel are most beneficial for other people to use. So if you guys know of other apps that you want to share with me, other websites, things that you think are really useful that have worked for you, let me know, leave it in the comments. Again, I can always do another updated video, but I just really wanted to speak to stuff that I've used personally, and because I've had a long run with all of these different platforms, I figured it would be a good video to make. If you guys have any questions, as always, feel free to ask me. Again, thanks for stopping by and watching, and thanks for all the support.